Okay, to understand what vitamin D does, we need to understand the central concept. The function of vitamin D is to maintain blood calcium. You probably think the function of vitamin D is to maintain strong bones and teeth, but it does that by accident. Its real function is to maintain your blood calcium level in a very narrow range. And the reason for that is, if your blood calcium level falls below about 9 milligrams per 100 milliliters, then you're longing to be in a big trouble and die rather quickly. And that's because blood calcium is important for muscle contraction and nerve transmission. And if you don't have enough of it, you can't contract muscles normally, there can't be normal nerve impulses. And this results in a disease called tetany, where you got these uncontrolled convulsions followed by rapid death. Calcium is also important for enzymic activities and blood clotting.
The debt today is so high, it's 200,000 rupees, 300,000 rupees of peasant who have no capital. They, who know within a year or two, when they accumulate that kind of debt, they will never be able to pay back. Where is the debt coming from? It's coming from a seed that is costing 100,000 to 200,000 rupees per kilogram, depending on what you got. Seed that used to be free, used to be theirs. Pesticides each time. The more they use, the more they have to use. 12 sprays, 15 sprays, 20 sprays. Pesticides used in just the last 5 years in the land areas of India has shot up by 2,000%. That's what the free market and globalization have brought. And since we are talking about peasants, who have no money, who have no capital, they can only buy expensive seeds and expensive pesticides by borrowing. And who lend them that money? The same companies that sell the pesticides, which are the same companies that sell the seeds, as you know, are now also the major creditors.
Far too many people often say things like animals do this, but we don't. Or this animal does this, and that animal does this, but the humans don't do things like that. Those statements have some hidden assumptions that we are not animals. When we say animals do this, animals do that, we often assume that we are not animals. If we are not animals, what are we? Are we plants, or trees, or flowers? No, we are not. Then okay, we are not plants. Then are we microorganisms, really tiny microscopy things? No, we are not. Then the natural conclusion must be we are not living things. That's not true. Yes, we are animals. And I see animals in us, and I see humans in animals. So I'm going to talk about the animal behavior and human nature. In order to understand human nature, we can look into animals' eyes and animal behavior and find something about what made us, who we are.
audio jungle.